I was rooting for you. We were all rooting for you.
It's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science here, chemistry PhD, skincare nerd, and beauty marketing connoisseur. The Inky List are a brand that I generally quite like. They're probably the main competitor to The Ordinary, which I also quite like. Both brands have lots of products, and there are lots of products from both brands that work well on my skin. They're both also really budget friendly, and it's hard to hate brands that are making skincare more financially accessible. Both brands are also quite sciencey in their marketing, so they put their ingredient names front and center. And I think that's gone a long way towards making everyone more comfortable with using synthetic chemicals that they might not be able to pronounce very easily. They have sort of scary-ish names. The whole natural is better, don't use ingredients you can't pronounce thing, I think really took a blow thanks to these brands. Recently, the Inky List released a new product, the Succinic Acid Acne Treatment. You've probably seen it all over social media. Inky are really busting out the marketing budget for this release. And honestly, I like this product a lot. It's been working really well for breakouts I've gotten. I put it on and overnight, it does seem to calm down a lot. But I'm finding the marketing around this product kind of shady, and I'm going to explain why. If you like this sort of nerdy beauty content, click the like, the subscribe, and the notification bell so you don't miss any videos. So first up, this is not a bad product. Like I said, it works really well on me, and I think there are very few truly bad products on the market. But there is a lot of dodgy marketing. I've been blogging about beauty products since 2011, so I've had a lot of time to read the press releases about new products, and I've gotten used to the sorts of marketing tricks that brands use. I'm not sure if it's intentional, but the marketing around the Inky List Succinic Acid Acne Treatment is kind of genius. Let's start by talking about succinic acid. Succinic acid is usually used as a pH adjuster or chelating agent in products, so it's playing a supporting role. It's not really an active. It has almost no peer-reviewed studies on it for acne. There are two papers on PubMed where succinic acid and acne are both mentioned, and they're from the same research group. The 2016 paper isn't actually really about succinic acid. The 2014 paper is the one where they actually did studies on it. Basically, staphylococcal epidermidis bacteria compete with C. acnes bacteria on your skin. Neither of them are really good or bad. They both contribute to acne, but they both also protect your skin against infections from other microbes. They both live inside acne pimples, and they're battling each other. Succinic acid is one of the chemicals that the staph bacteria might be using to keep the C. acnes bacteria in check. The researchers put succinic acid with C. acnes bacteria on one of these glass plates. They found that they needed a concentration of 5 millimolar to kill the bacteria. For comparison, they needed twice as much lactic acid and 50% more acetic acid. Acetic acid is the acid that you find in vinegar. Then they injected C. acnes bacteria into mouse ears to make them inflamed like a pimple would be. Then they injected succinic acid into them, and they found that both the number of bacteria and the inflammation decreased. Finally, they decided to skincare some mouse ears, so they injected the C. acnes bacteria again, and then they applied about 1% succinic acid onto them, and they found that again the bacteria counts and the inflammation decreased. Now, this is pretty promising, but this is far from enough evidence to say that it actually works against acne as a drug ingredient. If you're familiar with medicinal chemistry, then you'll know that there are millions and millions of compounds that work well on cells and on animals, but then they never turn out to be a drug because things that work well on cells and animals don't necessarily work well on humans in real life. The conditions on your skin are very different from the conditions on glass or on an animal. That's why you read about cures for cancer being found in Amazon rainforests, and then you never hear about them again. It's not because Big Pharma is suppressing the information, it's because that headline is based on in vitro or animal studies, and it never actually got tested on humans. That's why the Just Says in Mice Twitter account exists. There's also data from the chemical company that sells the succinic acid to brands showing that it decreases sebum. But there are basically no details on how the study was done, and a lot of supply studies are pretty low quality, so they'll have really small sample sizes, and sometimes the protocols are a bit rigged in the ingredient's favour, so it doesn't tell us much. The Inky List marketing material also says that succinic acid has been in European medical circles for a while. Now, this has been repeated in a lot of magazines, but it's a really ambiguous statement, and I haven't heard back from Inky List about what that actually means. I don't think it means that it's being used by European doctors to treat their patients for acne. I've asked a few derms and they've said they'd never heard of it, and we saw the complete lack of evidence before in the PubMed search results. So based on all of this, it isn't really surprising that no one's heard of succinic acid before. Clearly no big brands are excited enough about it to put it as the star ingredient in their products. A lot of ingredient checker sites don't even have a listing for it. Inki have chosen an ingredient that they pretty much have a monopoly on. This is nothing new. A lot of brands do choose ingredients that no one else is using because then there's a novelty factor and they can get people excited about their particular product. And putting ingredients into products that don't have a lot of evidence behind them, again, is nothing new. It happens all the time, and in general, I think it's a good thing. If everything had to be tested properly, then we would all be using about 3 products. To me, the big difference is that this product is actually regulated as a drug in the US. If you turn the packaging over, you can actually see the drug facts label. That's why Inki are allowed to have the word acne in the name of their product front and center. Acne is a medical condition, and you're only allowed to make products that claim to treat medical conditions if they're drugs. So this is an over-the-counter drug, just like sunscreen. You don't need a prescription to buy it, but it has a special status. It has this special status because it contains an ingredient that's been scientifically vetted to work. And that ingredient is salicylic acid, which is over here in size 4 font. On the legally required label, it's up here, it's got top billing, whereas succinic acid is over here under inactive ingredients. But you wouldn't know it if you were looking at the product name, the product packaging, the description of the product, all the marketing around the product, how everyone is talking about it, whether it's the beauty media, sponsored influencers, or unsponsored influencers. Succinic acid is always talked about like it is the top active ingredient that's treating the acne, and not the actual active ingredient. It's called the lead ingredient. Salicylic acid is supporting. This sort of marketing around fluff ingredients is pretty basic, standard, misleading beauty marketing 101 that you learn about the moment you start getting into skincare. It's where brands put a tiny sprinkle of exotic Jamaican sparkle flower into their product and then you turn it over and it turns out it's full of retinol. But it doesn't happen a lot with actual skincare drugs, and I don't know if it's because people realize that this would be pretty deceptive. It's like a drug claiming it's a herbal painkiller and you flip it over and it actually has codeine in it. Or if you have a sunscreen that calls itself a mineral sunscreen and then in size 4 font it has oxybenzone and avobenzone. Actually, that analogy doesn't work that well because at least zinc oxide is an actual approved sunscreen filter, so let's do raspberry oil. There are lots of people who genuinely think that raspberry oil is a good sunscreen because in one in vitro study with a dodgy protocol, it came out with an SPF of 28 to 50. So it's like a sunscreen that calls itself a raspberry oil sunscreen, but it also has standard amounts of oxybenzone and avobenzone in it. On the front, the oxybenzone and avobenzone is in size 4 font. But the marketing is all about how amazing raspberry oil is for sun protection, it's the next big thing, lots of doctors in Europe have been using it for decades, and then it says there are these supporting players, avobenzone and oxybenzone. Now Inki may genuinely believe that succinic acid is amazing for acne and it is the star player, and maybe it is the star player. But they're not legally allowed to say that. The level of evidence for succinic acid doesn't let them say this. I mean, it's a pretty interesting ingredient, but with no peer-reviewed studies that have actually used it on human skin, it's pretty dodgy that it's being marketed like it's a drug. That is less evidence than a lot of ingredients that we think are sort of fluffy, so things like bacuchiol and snail secretion. Those actually have multiple peer-reviewed studies on human skin. To do it properly, Inki should be submitting succinic acid for proper drug approval. So this involves rigorous trials on human skin rather than just on 10 mouse ears. If they do that, then succinic acid can join salicylic acid in that top box. But obviously, this is very expensive. But they're in a loophole where it's a sort of grey area and they don't actually have to do this because everyone's already assuming that succinic acid is a drug, that it is actively treating acne. Succinic acid is on the packaging right next to the word acne, it's impossible to miss. And you can see that this marketing is working really well if you look at articles in the beauty media. Succinic acid is the acne ingredient you should be using. Succinic acid is not an acne ingredient. This specific product is an acne treatment because it has salicylic acid, but that doesn't mean all of the ingredients in this are acne ingredients. They don't have the level of evidence for that. That's why they're in the bottom box with the label inactive ingredients. I wouldn't be anywhere near as annoyed if Inki just changed the name of their product and changed the marketing a bit so that salicylic acid was less of an afterthought. Let's say they called it the triple threat acne treatment with salicylic acid, succinic acid, and sulfur. Not all of their products have a single ingredient in the name, so why didn't they do that? Maybe they wanted to highlight how great they think succinic acid is, but maybe it's actually the cleverest part of this. At the moment, Inky have a monopoly on succinic acid. No one else uses it as their star ingredient, and no one snuck it into a drug product by using a different active drug ingredient. The way this has played out is that people hear that succinic acid is great for acne, they Google it, and conveniently, the only product that's made for acne with succinic acid is the Inkylist one. If they use salicylic acid as the headline ingredient, then you would come up with tons and tons of products. But because no one else is doing this, then Inky have basically made sure that all of this traffic searching for succinic acid ends up with this product, even if it ends up promoting misinformation. I don't know if Inky are marketing geniuses or they accidentally stumbled onto this strategy, but it is working really well. Step one, make a product that's classified as a drug because of well-tested ingredients that every other brand is already using. Step two, put the medical condition in the name of the product next to a little known ingredient. The less evidence for it, the better, because you'll have a search monopoly. Step three, promote the crap out of the product. You barely have to exaggerate because the product name does it for you. Every media outlet or influencer who talks about the product has to say the name, and that ingrains that relationship between the ingredient and the medical condition in everyone's minds. Step four, profit. I suspect a lot of brands are going to try to copy this because it is working so well for Inky. That's why I decided to make this video, even though I realize it might be a bit controversial, so we can spot brands doing this in the future and call them out. Again, I don't know if this was actually their intention, but the net effect is that everyone is being led to believe that succinic acid is an evidence-backed ingredient for treating acne. It is an actual drug that treats a medical condition. And for me, the worst part is I really like Inkylist, I really resonate with their values. I really like their emphasis on knowledge and education. And it is a perfectly good product. It works really well, everyone is gushing about it. It didn't need this. I was rooting for you, we were all rooting for you. So in conclusion, this is a good product, but it has bad marketing. It's misleading, maybe it's not intentionally deceptive, but that is the overall effect. So that's what I think. I don't know, what are your thoughts? Let me know in the comments. What do you think about Inkylist? What do you think about this specific product and the marketing? I hope you liked this video. If you did, click the thumbs up and the subscribe. You can also follow me on Instagram and check out my blog for more beauty science. See you next time to nerd out more.